Warhorse here. And this looks like it's going to be our front runner for next year's Buzzies for a movie that should have gone straight to DVD. They're going to be rebooting The Mummy. Starting over again, making it darker. Of course, everything needs to be darker nowadays. And the director of The Hunger Games, Gary Ross, is officially out for the next movie, catching fire because of money negotiational things. He's like, hey, I want more money for the next movie. And they're like, no, f*** you, you're fired. And the cast and crew of The Dark Knight Rises was interviewed by Entertainment Weekly, and you know, they asked various people various things, and they asked Tom Hardy about the controversy around his voice, and he said that it's a risk because it'll either be laughed at or it will be fresh and exciting. Yeah, I'm gonna go with laughed at. So, yay Venom! So look at that, look at all of that. And if you thought the Madea films were over, ho ho ho! You're wrong once again. Why do you keep thinking all these wrong things? If you're wondering what Madea's up to next, well, I don't, but hey, check it out if you do. And Christopher Nolan said that they shot over an hour's worth of footage of the movie with IMAX cameras. So you have to see it in IMAX. I mean, you have to. And a new trailer was released for Hotel Transylvania. This is the animated monster movie with voices by Adam Sandler and Andy Samberg. And it's about this hotel, which is keeps all these monsters in, and then Andy Samberg's a human, and it's like, oh, what? You're not supposed to be here? Craziness. And the third official trailer was just released for Brave. You get to see a lot more Brave things. And it looks more of like a journey about this girl finding herself. I can't really tell who the bad guy is. Is it the bear? I don't know, but look at it. Brave, brave, brave. And finally, the trailer was just released for The Road. No, not the Viggo Mortensen Road. Another movie called The Road. See, this is why this is too confusing. You should rename your movie to The Road Assembles. All right, on Friday I asked you which movies you just hated the ending to. So here's our top five movies that we did not like the ending to. First of all, runner-up was Mass Effect, just because it was a video game. I didn't include it, but you guys said Mass Effect a lot, so you must really did not like the ending of that video game. The Mist, actually I like the ending of The Mist just because it's so f***ed up. And the number one movie you did not like the ending to was The Gray. Oh yeah, The Gray. Oh my God, The Gray. And one of the head people over at Marvel said that, you know, at some point Robert Downey Jr. is just not going to want to make any more Iron Man films. They're trying to figure out, you know, what they're going to do about, you know, the next step for that. They said they actually do not want to reboot it down the road and actually do a James Bond effect where you just replace the actor and continue the story, which is a great idea. Great idea. And I guess last week was CinemaCon, which I guess is a big convention for movie things. I had no idea about it. I wanted to go. Anyway, I guess there was some discussion about trying to bring texting back into the movie theaters. Because people were saying like, oh yeah, my kids were so involved with texting, movies should be more interactive. No! Movies is about escapism. It's about, oh, I don't have to deal with my current shit right now because I'm watching a movie. Someone bleeps up little lights like, oh yeah, I'm in reality and this fucking asshole's on their phone. If you can't sit still for 2 hours, then don't go to the movies. Texting, get the fuck out of here. Leonardo DiCaprio looking totally badass. This photo is The Rock grilling like a human hand, which is kind of cool. But every news source I went to today collecting news, every one of them has some kind of pun about, can you smell what The Rock is cooking over the photo? Every one of them. You can't get any more clever than that. He's clearly cooking, and you go right to his catchphrase, laziness. But I know in America, we're getting that for sure, so in your face. But you'll probably see it anyway too, so also, I've come across a bootleg version of the entire movie online. I'm not going to link to it. You can Google it if you want to search for it. I just recommend not doing that because you don't want your first experience to be like, oh, I remember when I saw The Avengers. It was on a 7-inch screen across my computer. No, you want to see it in IMAX. So don't cheat yourself, but if you want to cheat yourself, that exists. And also last week in a landslide victory, all you guys said you're planning on seeing The Dark Knight Rises in IMAX. Of course, we all are. Well, we're all going to try to.